are back here in the Media Center, and sometimes it's amazing who you can bump into. We found David Charles, the Senior Director of Championships with the PGA, and here on Championship Sunday of the PGA Championship, the final round. Every time it's been at Valhalla, we've gone to a playoff. Do you think that's a possibility today?
Well, we prepare for it. Obviously, we have the history here at Valhalla recently with, obviously, Tom Watson winning the Senior PGA Championship, the last event held here. But Tiger Woods and the Bob May playoff was outstanding. So we'll be prepared. It's a three-hole playoff, 16, 17, and 18. And if we don't have a champion in, we'll go back, we'll play 18, and then it'll be a hole-by-hole till we determine who the winner is.
Yeah, we're in for a lot of excitement either way. I think we're going to see a lot of birdies out there and just a great final round. But talking about the winner, he gets a lot of things, not just bragging rights, not just points, but he gets a lot of swag with this.
Well, he sure does. Obviously, he's a major champion once he hoists that Wanamaker trophy on 18 green. But comes with that, PGA Championship has the highest purse in major championship golf, $1.8 million to the champion. And as the champion leaves the 18th green, we go into what we call the PGA Champions Toast. And Ted Bishop, the president of the PGA of America, will present a few goodies. One is the champion's money clip. The other is an Omega watch from one of our official patrons. And then also a replica trophy, a 90% replica trophy of the Wanamaker. His name is already inscribed on it. We have an engraver on property to do that this afternoon. That's the champion's trophy for life. And then they also offer an invitation to play in the PGA Grand Slam of Golf, a season-ending event in Bermuda, where the four major champions come together to play a 36-hole exhibition. And right now, we've already got Bubba Watson, Martin Kaymer, Rory McIlroy, so it's setting up to be a great field. So lots of fun stuff for the champion.
Yeah, very cool out there, and amazing how quickly they can get that engraved and out to the champion. But talking about getting people out here today, we've got some important updates with parking. So what's going on? What do people need to know before they head out to the course?
Well, sure. We did make two changes to our parking lots. One is Lot V, the volunteer lot. They will now park at Churchill Downs. And also Lot B, as in boy, the distillery lot, they also will park at Churchill Downs. So there was some different reports of going elsewhere, but Churchill Downs is the place to go for both of those parking lots. And that's our main spectator parking lot. So we've planned all along. The buses will be very frequent and get everybody right here to Valhalla, dropping them out right there on 17 Green in the heart of the action.
Yeah, you don't want to miss any of that today. And talking about Valhalla, it seems like there have been very few snags this week. You know, aside from the weather, we can't do anything about that, but a great place to have the PGA Championship. What do you think that Louisville and Valhalla does right when they host this event?
Well, the fans come out, and we've had the highest ticket sales of all time here this week at the PGA Championship here at Valhalla. So great fan base, great corporate base, the infrastructure of Valhalla. PGA of America owns this property. We've built the infrastructure to be able to have these adverse weather conditions and still get people around very easily. So Valhalla is a great asset for the PGA of America, and I'm sure we'll come back here many, many more times.
Absolutely, yes. We would love to have this excitement back. I'm personally really sad that this is the final day, but we will have a lot of excitement coming up later. David Charles, thank you very much for joining us.